What up? This is Rama Screen covering movies, TV, and entertainment. And here's my review of Amazon Prime Video's new competition series, World's Toughest Race, Eco Challenge Fiji. Hey, before you watch my review, please subscribe to my channel, press that like button, and ring that bell so you can get notified whenever I post new videos. And if you would like to help support this channel, please do so at patreon.com/ramascreen. That's patreon.com/ramascreen. Let's rock this. First up, I would like to say thank you to Amazon Prime Video for granting me the screener to this entire new show. Wait, let me elaborate that further because it's really technically not a new show, come to think of it. You see, Eco Challenge is a reality series that originated back in the mid-90s, created by Mark Burnett, who also gave you Survivor and The Apprentice. Eco Challenge stopped running in 2002, partly because the TV network did not want to renew it, and partly because Mark Burnett was busy on cloud nine of the successes of those two other shows that I mentioned earlier. Well, fast forward to now, World's Toughest Race Eco Challenge Fiji is basically the revival, or the reboot, if you will. The entire race was filmed last year, and it will finally premiere on August 14th on Amazon Prime Video. They've asked me to not spill spoilers, including which teams drop out, which teams got disqualified, which teams won the bloody thing. But hey, it's totally understandable, because every outcome of this race is part of this show's appeal. The host this time is none other than the famous Bear Grylls. I think Bear is an okay host. He can be a bit awkward at times on this show. He would often reach in for a hug, even though clearly the other person valued his personal space. So anyway, in this Ultimate Expedition race, there are 66 teams from 30 countries going at it non-stop for 11 days, 24 hours a day, across unforgiving 671 kilometers of rugged terrains in the island of Fiji, which is filled with mountains and thick jungles and surrounded by vast oceans. So in total, there are about 330 participants, and they come in the forms of teams of five, including four racers and an assistant crew member. So there you go. That's the whole layout. It's pretty straightforward from the bird's eye viewpoint. But man, once you're on the ground, literally going through those miles, it is easier said than done. Do the teams have to complete obstacles and challenges along the way? Yes, but really, they're not all that difficult compared to the grueling condition and the far distances between each checkpoint. When your body is not used to handle such long exposure and such stress, it can shut down on you, even if you don't want it to. Watching this show is a little nerve-wracking, at least for me. There are close calls when somebody almost gets swept away by a raging river, or when somebody's tethering on the edge of a cliff. I imagine the liability waiver forms that they had to sign prior to the show must have been quite lengthy. But some moments do make me smile and warm my heart, especially when Fiji locals help the participants out by teaching them how to build a raft or giving them shelter for the night. I think it's cool that the show does not forbid the locals from lending a hand. The life stories that these participants bring with them, the diversity they champion, the different purposes or the different motivations for why they signed up, these are the things that will have you be fixated more than just about who reaches the finish line at the best time. I prefer watching Eco Challenge rather than Survivor or The Apprentice, for example, because on those other shows, scheming and backstabbing are part of its nature. They are highly encouraged. Whereas Eco Challenge, it forces you to check your ego, especially when your teammate is struggling. There is a paradigm shift involved, and it's a humbling, life-altering, appreciative experience, especially when you interact with another culture, that lives in abject poverty. Of course, we all want to know which team ultimately wins. We all do. And every one of those participants are obviously driven and ambitious. But I think you'll find World's Toughest Race Eco Challenge Fiji to be a much more wholesome show than that.